Hi, it's Dan Veall, and welcome to another one of my reviews in Guitar Interactive magazine. We are looking at the amazing Quad Capture from Neural DSP. This is the latest incarnation of top quality modeling processors, and there is so much on board this processor. Today, I'm just going to do an overview. I'm going to look at some of the main features, and hopefully you'll be as excited as I am and you'll want to go out and try one of these out for yourself. I've created a few patches on board and I've made up some sounds, some of which you've heard already in the opening introduction, and I'm going to run through how I've created some of those and some of the features on board the Quad Capture itself. Right then, let's get started. What have we got? Well, let's do the main guts first. The Quad Capture is a quad processor, 2 GHz SHARC processor based system. It is a multi-effects unit which uses a method of capturing profiles of amplifiers, distortion boxes, and speaker cabinets, as well as piles and piles and piles of other inbuilt effects. The device is a massive collaboration with producers and sound designers all across the world to bring top-notch amplifier captures to you to have on your desk, which is absolutely insane, absolutely bonkers. At time of release, there's already 50 amplifiers on board, over 70 effects, and thousands of impulse responses that, as we'll see later on, have been arranged into one very, very neat little applet that you can get to and dial in some absolutely incredible speaker capture sounds. Getting onto the face of the unit, something I like immediately, is we have a touch screen here. Now, as I said earlier on, I have created a few patches of my own, and this one here I've actually created with a view to use on stage immediately, and it didn't actually take too long to copy my previous signal path onto this device and have something which was going to be useful for me before I started tweaking. On the screen you can see I essentially have a long signal path from top left-hand corner down to bottom right-hand corner. So my signal path is my instrument coming in here, and I've got some different paths going on, running in parallel, and then some different effects down on the second row here and going out to separate outputs. I'm going to run you through those very, very quickly so you can see what's going on. And what we'll do is we'll create a patch so you can see how easy it is to actually add effects into your signal path. For example, I started in my input, and up here, if I just touch the screen, I have got a high pass filter where I'm just rounding off my very, very low end. This is great because it means I can sculpt my signal going in with a view to a holistic view of my signal path. So I want to get rid of all these sub-frequencies immediately, the kind of stuff which is just going to flap speakers around and be pretty useless. I'm going to get rid of those immediately. So I've added this block in. Coming out of that block, just by touching on the screen, you can see I've got another block here and I've got a compressor. And the compressor at the moment is switched off. I can switch that on and off in just a moment. And if I move along, I have got some captures that I've put in here. This is a capture of an Ampeg SVT2, which interestingly, I have one of those sat behind me, the real thing, as it were. And you get the idea. I can go across. I've got an EQ in here that I've put in for my signal path. And down here, I've got a distortion effect that I've put in. There we go. That's my EQ again. And down across the bottom here, I've got a whole bunch of modulations and delays and choruses and the like. Now, immediately I have got a patch, but what I really want to do is be able to manipulate that so I can switch sounds on and off. Okay, let's do that really, really quickly. There are three modes, three main play modes on Quad Capture. The first one is preset mode. Now, when I've created this signal path, that's my preset. And I can save presets in loads of banks, just loads. So I couldn't run out on a gig, I don't think. There are so many places to save my presets. So for example, this is preset 1B. And as you can see, the LED is lit on B here and I'm on bank one. I can use the bank button up here to go to bank two, and I've got another eight presets, go up to bank three, and I've got another eight presets, la da 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 da. You can see where this is going. And I can switch between different presets. So this one I've got nothing on because I'm going to use this later on. Okay, over here I've got my Dan Veall bassist preset I've just created. H over here, we're going to look at this in a moment. I've created a very simple Ampeg SVT stack, and we're going to look at that in detail. On G, this is great. I've actually had, this is a patch by Eric Arco, who is a Neural DSP user, and he sent me this patch by the app, which I'm also going to mention in just a bit. Okay, let's come back over to my preset here, and let's look at mode number two. I'm going to skip over to what would be the simplest idea of setting up my pedal board, and this is to be able to switch effects on and off as if they are boxes in front of me. So this is what I've done. I've set up the eight pedals for the boxes that I most want to stamp on in a gig. So pedal A, if you watch the screen, is that compressor that I just pointed out a moment ago, and I can toggle that on and off, like so. On my bottom row, I've set up some different modulation type effects. So on G over here, I'm turning my chorus effect on and off. Okay, let's have a listen to it. This is my chorus effect. There's some distortion in there as well. I forgot that I left that switched on, but that's fine, we can hear that. I might decide that I want like a time-based type effect going on, some reverb. great for creating some really lovely sort of ethereal kind of sounds in a band situation. So you can see that I can turn my stomp boxes on and off, and actually going into each of these effects. So for example, the reverb, just while I think about it, you can choose which button is going to be assigned to that effect. So in this case, you press the assign button and hit H and it'll assign immediately. I mean, it's like a 2 second job and I've got my effect assigned to a particular button. And as I said, I can turn them all on and off. Like so, which is really, really cool. What I can't do in this mode, because it's designed, I think, to be a really simple layout, is to be able to change parameters and multiple effects on a sort of a wider sort of view. And this is where scene mode comes in. And the idea being is I've still got my patch, but I can now assign different parameters, levels, or the speed of a modulation, and also switching on and off multiple effects to one button. So for example, in B here, which I used earlier on, I've got this nice bassy filter. If I switch to scene 8, it actually turns off the drive, turns off the filter, it changes the EQ to add some more brightness, and it switches on the reverb and the delay, and we've got that effect that I used in my intro. Immediately I can switch to a really nice rich sound, which might be the introduction of one song, switch to distortion for a chorus, etc., etc., etc. And it just gives me a greater control over my sounds from song part to song part. Interestingly, for the reverbs and delays, I can set those to spill over, so I can play, switch to the new scene, and I'll get a spillover of the effects. So it doesn't suddenly just stop when I hit the pedal. That is absolutely fantastic. Again, there's so many more details that I could go into about these parameters, but I'm just trying to keep this as light as possible. Okay then, so let's have a look at changing the parameters inside a patch. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna switch to my preset H over here, which I've called SVT Bass 1. And let's have a look at the individual effects that I've put in. Okay, I've got a compressor, pretty standard fare for us bassists. I've got a capture of an Ampeg head. And we're also going to be look at the cabinet captures as well. So we can look at that in detail. Adding effect is dead simple. I'm going to do this really, really quickly so you can just see how simple it is using the touch screen. I can touch the screen and there we go. I've got a menu immediately of the kind of effects that I might want to add, and I can scroll through and I can choose something. Let's put in a modulation and I'm going to very, very quickly choose a vintage chorus. There we go. I've stuck it right at the start of the chain. That's it, done. We go. I can press back on the effects, and now can you see I've got these controls have lit up and they correspond to the individual parameters, dials, in the effect itself. So look closely, top left hand corner, I've got the mix. I can turn it up and down. Each button here is actually a rotary controller. And I can change all the parameters as I go along. Now, immediately, I've seen on the internet, people have been asking, the rotary dials, I mean, they seem a bit wobbly. Are they going to last being stamped on? They are really solid. And I know that Neural have gone through a lot of testing with giving these a lot of grief. No, actually, they do feel really, really solid. There's going to be a limit to the movement that this metal piece can have. And it's not going to go too far. It's not going to break anything inside, unless you're like stamping on the top of the device with all your might, which really you shouldn't be doing anyway. Okay, anyway, enough about rotary controllers. I can switch on and off the effects manually here, like so. And I, as I said, I've got my parameters for each of the effects. So this one, threshold, ratio, attack, release, makeup gain, and my mix, and I can blend to my heart's content. And when I hit save, they are saved in that particular effect. Okay, let's have a look at the captures then. I really want to do this. This is my amplifier capture, and at the moment, got a little bit of compression on just to tidy things up because I'm going to slap it to bass. Here we go. Yeah, that sounds really, really great straight off bat. All I've done is I've added those effects and I added a little bit of bass and treble and left the speaker capture basically as it was. I chose the speaker that I wanted and away I went. And that sounds really, really good. In my studio, it sounds brilliant. I've got some nice big speakers here. Of course, listen through decent earphones. If you listen to this on a phone or a laptop, you just aren't gonna get the low end of bass guitar. It's gonna be completely pointless. But I can tell you that in comparison to other captures that I use, these are brilliant. These are absolutely fantastic. So the settings on the amplifier mimic the real thing. And as I say, I've got an SVT2 sat behind me, and this does feel and sound very familiar. It's really good, and I would have no qualms about using this immediately in a live situation. Dial it in, plug it into the PA, use some IEMs, and you're laughing. I mean, my SVT weighs about 30 kilos or something. This will go in the same bag as my bass guitar, and I can throw it over my shoulder. I know which one I prefer the idea of, even though there is something rather luscious about a big hefty valve amp behind you. Yeah, anyway, let's move on. Let's have a look at the speaker captures. I really want to show you this. So clicking on my speaker cabinet emulation, we are greeted with what looks like a fairly intense window. There's some really good stuff going on here though, because essentially what we have is, imagine a speaker cabinet with two microphones put on it. In a studio situation, the position of each microphone in comparison to each other and the position of the microphone around the cone all makes a big difference. Not only that, the type of microphone that you use and the type of cabinet. So what Neural have done is they have profiled every single microphone on board in all the different positions on a whole array of different cabinets. So you can imagine that we'll have hundreds, no, thousands of impulse responses that they have taken for every single small position of the microphone. Now, would you rather have a menu of 1,000 different IRs that you've got to go through, or would you rather have a graphic user interface that allows you to do this in a virtual world? Where did they have their microphone? Well, it was here. Well, what happens if I move the microphone over here? Well, here's the speaker cone and the dot is the microphone. As you can see, I can move it around on screen, or I can use the dials at the top to set the position and distance of this microphone onto this particular cabinet. And the same for the other microphone as well. You might decide, actually, do you know what? I really like the sound of just one microphone. That's great, because you can just turn the other one off. Easy. Furthermore, you can also choose what type of microphone. And there's loads in here. I'm not even gonna go through them. We've got everything from ribbon mics to dynamic microphones. They're all in there, and you can just mix and match to your heart's content. And when you've got a sound you really, really like, save it, bang, away you go. You've got yourself an amplifier and a cabinet combination that you can send out to your PA, your monitors, your in-ear monitors. Or, because this device can be a recording interface, yes, it's an audio interface as well, plug it straight into your recording workstation and get some absolutely amazing top quality amp captures straight down. And you can print it and you can be laughing. It's going to sound absolutely fantastic. Now, when we have set up our patch and we have assigned each of these different effects to the pedals, then sure enough, we can switch between preset mode, stomp mode, and scene mode. Now, I was doing it on screen earlier on, but in a live situation, you probably don't want to bend down and touch the screen. You can actually switch between those modes by using the two buttons over here. Now, I'm going to lean over and just use the palm of my hand to get a good push on it, but, you know, imagine it's my foot. And I can switch between the modes, preset, scene, stomp, absolutely immediately. And in this situation, I have set up each of the individual effects on a stomp. Of course, in scene mode, I could set the amplifier to have more drive, or I could set the compressor to be really, really squishy, and I can set those up on the pedals. And even with three effects, I've got a multitude of different sounds available. This is amazing. I think this is absolutely fantastic. I'm trying to keep calm here because I really, really like this. I'm very enthusiastic about some of the control that you can have without having to go through lots of menus and using less amount of buttons and switches to be able to access your parameters. I really, really like this. Other features on board, very, very quickly, we've got tap tempo. So if I've got delays and I want them to correspond with the beat of the music, maybe I'm playing with a band and they're playing a bit faster than usual, I can tap tempo. So when I switch in my delays, they are in time with the music. There's also a tuner on board as well. I can get to the tuner by holding down bottom right hand button, and my bass is probably out of tune because it's gotten a bit warm in here. Okay, strangely sharp. Never mind, but you can sort of see and you can immediately just tune in like so. This is really, really smooth like that. And we're all in tune. That's quite funny. Okay, and then just come straight out by hitting one of the buttons again and you're right back to your screen where you had before. Right, okay then, so 7-inch color touchscreen screen here. It is a 1.8mm hardened glass screen. So although it's quite a lot of real estate there to sort of catch a heel or anything like that, I'm hoping it's gonna be nice and strong on stage. And to be honest, I'd probably put this behind a monitor or something like that to keep it away from stray feet. But it looks pretty solid, as is the whole shell. This is an anodized aluminium shell. It's really, really dead light, and it's got some vents on the side to keep it nice and cool because the processor is going to be doing rather a lot of work. On board then, so we've got Wi-Fi. So you don't even need to connect via USB cable. You can set up a Wi-Fi connection to your home router or even a hotspot to your phone. And Neural also supply an app. And that app allows me to share my patches with my friends and fellow musicians and people across the world. And also means I can download some of their captures as well. So if somebody has made a really, really good Soldano capture that I really want to use with my SVT capture, and I want to blend the two together to have a nice meaty distorted bass sound, I don't have to have that amp in front of me. I can use someone else's capture and put the two together to make my own patches. That's brilliant, because you know, if you're new to this and you want to do some captures but you're not sure how to go about it, then the massive Neural community are going to be on hand to be able to help you just by grabbing some patches. Not to mention, obviously, Doug and the team at Neural have created loads of captures. I haven't even been through them. Click in the menu and it's scroll. There is so much to choose from there, including, I think, pretty much all of the dark glass amp heads and cabinets are in there as well. So, you know, you're not just getting a processor here, you're getting most of Dark Glass's product catalog as well, which is fantastic. Anyway, I'm gonna round up. Anything I've missed, I'm gonna put up in the written review, but as a very, very quick tour of the Quad Capture, I hope this has made sense to you, and you can see why I'm so enthusiastic about it. Massive connections on the back, stereo ins and outs, XLR outputs to your amplifier. We've also got inputs for pedals as well, so real-time control. I mean, there is just so much on board this. It's good. It's good. I'm not giving it back. I really like it. So there we go. I hope you have found this little review useful. This is the Neural DSP Quad Capture. I've been Dan Veall. Thanks ever so much for watching, and I will catch up with you again soon.